Well, good cold morning to everybody. After playing once around the state yesterday and seeing many different climates, I was attempting to get to Olympia by way of Seattle, Yakima, Spokane, Yakima, Seattle, ultimately to Lacey. We got there. But today, we're here today to announce the completion of the improvements to the Greene Street Bridge. It is a project that early on in my administration was brought to my attention as really having a choke point on the movement of much of our traffic, and the improvements reopen important regional shipping corridor for us, and in many ways enhances the adjacent community and the adjacent neighborhoods that were feeling the impact of that diverted traffic. In essence, which is amazing to me, 30% of the truck traffic within the city limits relies on this bridge. And so when this bridge has restrictions on it, that traffic goes elsewhere into our community. Improvements completed this month increased the load certification on the Greene Street Bridge to accommodate all legal loads. It also returns truck traffic to the designated truck traffic routes, which, like I said, is key to other neighborhoods throughout our city. Previous load restrictions diverted larger trucks down Mission through the Logan Neighborhood to Division and through downtown. Fuel carriers and other freight haulers came to me early in 2012 to outline the costly problems this has on rerouting their truck traffic. So not only impacts on our neighborhoods, but truly impacts on the viability of our businesses here in the city. Improving the Greene Street Bridge was a pressing need, and it was important that we took the time to do this project right. A full bridge replacement would have cost somewhere between $11 and $12 million and taken years. The North Spokane Corridor project will include a new bridge across the Spokane River, but this still is sometime into the future, and many of us watch that on an annual basis of making that happen. What we came up with was a $1.7 million solution that took about 3.5 months to complete, achieving the certification that allows heavier traffic to safely utilize the Greene Street Bridge at a more affordable cost is key in this project. The total final costs of the improvements include some unexpected costs for epoxy ejections as we looked at making sure that this was safe and obviously removing those weight restrictions. The original estimates for the cost that came back at about $988,000, but the principal engineer Ken Brown's close work with our contracting partner Leewens reduced that cost to about $520,000. I want to thank Leewens for their willingness to look at creative solutions that helped cut the original estimates in almost in half. Lisa Leewens is here today, Leewens Connor, a principal in the firm, and Doug Briggs, project manager, both here today representing Leewens, and will speak in a moment. Money from the Spokane Regional Transportation Council and the Arterial Street Fund paid for the Greene Street Bridge improvements. And again, it shows the significance of this regional solution and regional transportation freight corridor for us, of the importance it's had to deal with the Spokane Regional Transportation Council. And I would like to thank them for their support. I sit on that council, but it truly is a regional council. And so thank you to them, Kevin Wallace, and to the staff at the SRTC for supporting this project and my fellow members on that board that voted for funding for this. I also want to acknowledge Council members Amber Waldrop and Mike Fagan, who represent this part of our city and again is a key component of alleviating this traffic in our Logan neighborhood. Both played important roles of conduit to the neighborhoods as we worked through this solution. And again, thank you to Kevin Wallace and the Spokane Regional Transportation Council as important partners as we look at regional solutions that are cost-effective and affordable in this, and particularly across our partner municipalities. You know, this is all part of, and many of you have seen it, as the Spokane Links initiative of really linking not only our freight corridors, but also our neighborhood corridors, our neighborhood streets. It's all part of an integrated solution that we see across our community. And this is just one part of that, but in a major way shows that making sure that proper planning, regional partnerships is a key way of making sure our transportation infrastructure is what it needs to be. I'll be followed now by the principal of Leewens, and it'd be great to have you come speak.
Thank you very much. Nice to see you. Good morning, everyone. I would like to start by thanking Mayor Condon and the people of Spokane for giving us the opportunity to restore and strengthen the Greene Street Bridge. It's going to be strong for many, many years of stable and safe use with heavier truckloads. We particularly enjoyed working with Ken Brown, Mike Cash, Kyle Tuhig, and Merrick Kay. The project went extremely well. The bridge is noticeably stiffened and strengthened. Noticed by our tremendous crews working underneath the bridge deck. During our surface preparation process, we epoxy injected cracks that were over 15 mils wide, or approximately 1/64 of an inch. Going into the colder weather, we required enclosure and heat for anything below 40 degrees. Our crews completed this efficiently, safely, and at our high quality standards. Carbon fiber strengthening was used to retrofit this project. Often called FRP, carbon fiber is also used to build race cars and airplanes. FRP is 10 times stronger than steel, and it does not corrode. It adds years of life to concrete structures. Near surface material, or NSM, was used on the roadway, similar to carbon fiber rebar. Greene Street Bridge is one of the largest FRP projects in the Pacific Northwest. The city of Spokane is on the leading edge by using FRP and NSM on its bridges. Again, a big thank you from all of us at Leewens Corporation for allowing us to help improve your vital transportation system and remove load restrictions from the Greene Street Bridge. Also, a thank you to our subs who helped us with this project: Spokane Traffic Control, Aztec Electric, and Tracon Saw Cutting. Thank you very much.
So Lisa, the city bridge engineer, are you here with us? Right? You're gonna help me do this? So the only thing left is to remove the weight restriction.
Thank you.